I chose my sexuality because I had femininity in me, but I was not a woman.
We as human beings, we don't choose to be born as what we are.
Transgender is not in our Hindu religion, so we always oppose it.
Imagine you no longer have to choose between male or female on any legal form. The third gender revolution is happening here in India. The Supreme Court legally acknowledged the right to choose your own gender beyond male or female as an essential part of freedom of expression.
Supreme Court ne hum log ko aaj izzat samman.
Does castration happen?
Of course.
The impact of this law transcends class and social status. And from one of the largest cities, Mumbai, to a small town of Raigarh, I'm about to take the journey and explore how this impacted people's lives. Join me. Scripture. Transgender community known as the Hijras here in India were revered. It was during British colonialism that they were criminalized. Indian society has held this tension. On the one hand, they wanted their blessings in different ceremonies. On the other hand, they ostracized them in daily life, forcing many into prostitution and begging on the street. As a result, the Hijra community became closed and secretive. Almost no Indians have seen the inside world of a Hijra's life. Today, I have rare access into that world. I'm about to meet Lakshmi, one of the forces that took the case all the way to the Supreme Court and helped change India's law.
A basic question.
Yes.
What's the proper way to refer to it? Is it Hijra? Is it Kinnar?
Kinnar is the traditional Vedic, Hindu Vedic word. Kinnar is okay. A divine. Kinnar means the sub-demigod. Hijra means a person who leaves his or her own tribe in search of his true self. I was born in a Brahmin family, one of the elite Brahmin families. The doctor decided that I was a male, but I believed that I was never a man. I was sexually abused at a very young age because of my femininity.
How old were you?
I was very young. I was about 7 or 6 years old. And one day when I was, I believe, 14 years old, when I had the guts to say no, and when I had the guts to say no, the whole world changed.
At what point your mother and you, or your father and you, had that discussion?
You know what
about
happened?
Acknowledging.
Yeah, my family came to from the idiot box, you know, from the television. Section 377 discussion had gone. And there was a press conference, and I landed up in that press conference. In that time, I said, we should have a constitutional right, we should have the basic human rights. I just said it. And for the first time, it was like the world, the press was like, oh my God, she's speaking English. For them, me speaking English was a big deal. They had only seen Hijras clapping, begging, selling body, or, you know, doing the traditional blessing ceremonies. And over there I stand, you know, in a black sari with a sleeveless blouse, you know, talking about my rights. And then I get a phone call from my family and they said, come home. The biggest thing happens is get the child married, you know. I said, are you gone blind?
They wanted to marry you.
Yeah. Then I said, are you gone blind that you don't see your own child, what your child is? So I said, if you'll force me, I'll leave the home and I'll go and castrate myself. My parents were silent for a moment, and then my father had a tear rolling down his cheek. And he said, okay, fine. And he said, you would require your own space. It was very unusual for any Indian family, immaterial to caste, religion, or, you know, to accept a child which is a transgender so openly. Rather, that was a point in my family that people wanted to get me killed because I was a black spot to the Brahmin clan.
You threatened your parents of doing castration. Does castration happen?
Of course.
Lakshmi has emerged as the voice of the transgender rights movement in India, even representing this marginalized community at the United Nations. In 2014, Lakshmi's impassioned testimony to the Indian Supreme Court led to the legal recognition of the third gender, stating it is the right of every human being to choose their own gender.
I chose my sexuality because I had femininity in me, but I was not a woman. and the third gender.
Has the Supreme Court's ruling changed the societal attitude?
Of course, now we are legal entity. I have the right to choose whether I'm a third gender, I'm a woman, or I'm a man. The Supreme Court says my dignity has to be restored by the state and the federal government.
You mentioned many of the Hijra community was forced into sex
work. It's not only India, it's around the world that we are forced into sex work. Because at the ground level, you don't get a job. You're discriminated because of the way you dress up. You're discriminated the way you speak. You're discriminated even because you have a loud expression of your own emotions.
That's a very good point.
So, what else a transgender does?
And the clientele are usually men.
Of course, who else come? Gay men are not interested in my femininity. Gays will be only interested in men. I don't want to know what the men who sleep with me are called, because they have always said they are heterosexual.
Now, you said in your book, you described Vicky, the man who has absolutely overpowered me and made me a woman.
When I met this guy, he was like a mirror. As much as I love him, he loves me back.
She cooked for me. She's a Brahmin woman and she did it for me.
It is not me. I'm not a woman who will cook. But love teaches you to cook. In public, we are always together and we go as dignified as any man and woman would go on this planet Earth. It's all about love. Unconditional love.
What do you think of hijras?
I think it's also part of a society, you know. We have to give a respect to them.
We as human beings, we don't choose to be born as what we are. I never chose to be born as a girl.
Transgender is not in our Hindu religion, so we always oppose it.
Though the Supreme Court ruling is still a work in progress, what is so inspiring about Indian society is that the society is trying. There are corporations such as Red Label that's selling tea, a major product in India, takes on the issue and makes it a major part of its advertisement. But there are also some resistance. There are people who still refuse the concept and reject it for religious or cultural reasons. It is definitely a work in progress, but one that is still revolutionary to its core.
Now I'm leaving Mumbai and traveling 800 miles to the town of Raigarh, where they elected the country's first third gender mayor since the Supreme Court ruling.
This is the gateway to Raigarh. I'm exhausted, but I'm so looking forward to meet the mayor and actually explore how this issue is impacting everyone, even those living in the heart of India. So I just arrived Raigarh only to witness a major celebration for the Ganesh Festival. It is so exciting and they say it's good luck. Just for you.
Mayor Madhu was gracious to let us into her home at night. Kinners or hijras are often wary of outsiders and suspicious of attention. It took a lot of convincing to get her to agree to meet.
Yes?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much. What is the Kinnar lifestyle like?
देश में ladies गिनते आते हैं और अलग से अपनी जिंदगी जीते हैं लोग. ना उनका शादी होता है, ना उनके जिंदगी में कोई प्यार मुंह बताता है. ये किन्नर जिंदगी है, अकेली जिंदगी है. बस किन्नर का परिवार किन्नर होते हैं. वो तो माँ बाप भाई बहन तो अपने रिश्ते से जुड़े हैं, खून के रिश्ते से, और बाकी किन्नर का समाज किन्नर परिवार ही होता है.
How did your parents react when they first noticed?
कि मेरे परिवार वाले ऐसा कोई कुछ फीलिंग नहीं करते थे कि किन्नर ऐसा, और गरीब घर से हैं और किन्नर की हूँ, और नाच गा के अपना तो पैसा चलता ही रहता था. ऐसे में ऐसा ये छत्तीसगढ़ है और ये सादा सिंपल सी शहर है, छोटी सी, इसमें ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता है कि तुम ऐसे कर रहे हो तो तुमको गांव से निकाल दें कि समाज से निकाल दें कि घर परिवार से. डैडी भी चाहते थे, कोई परेशानी नहीं था.
Tell me about your upbringing. You said you came from a very humble family.
मैं आठवीं तक गई, आठवीं बाद नहीं पढ़ी मैं, क्योंकि गरीबी स्थिति थी, काम काज करने वाले कोई नहीं थे, डैडी अकेले थे उसके, इसलिए पढ़े हुए छोड़ के अपना काम काज में लग गए थे हम लोग. मैंने ऐसे जंगल में लकड़ी लेने जाना, रोजी मजदूरी, ईंटा गिट्टी के काम करना. जी मैं ट्रेन में मांगने भी जाती थी पहले.
But why the begging?
क्योंकि काम में कोई रखते नहीं है और सब दिन. तो आज मैं मेयर बनी हूँ किन्नर समाज से, तो मैं चाहती हूँ सबके लिए घर एक आँख हो जाए सरकार की तरफ से, और कुछ व्यवस्था कमाने का जरिया छोटा मोटा योजना, किसी से लड़े झगड़ा किसी के हाथ फैलाना पड़े.
In years past, two transgender mayors were elected by the people, but they were both removed from office by the courts over disputes about their true gender. So Madhu is the first third gender mayor in India to serve openly with the blessing of the Supreme Court.
You are a trailblazer. Were there any resistance for you running for a mayor?
मुझे मना मेरे डैडी किए थे, मेरे भाई लोग किए थे, क्योंकि पहले और कभी 20-25 साल पहले कोई किन्नर ऐसी चुनाव पे लड़ी थी तो उनका ऐसी दुश्मनी से मर्डर हो चुका. मैंने ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता, पहले ज़माना दूसरा था, अब के ज़माने दूसरे हैं. पूरे रायगढ़ जितने थे सब मेरे ही एक तरफा मैंने जीत गई थी करके मुझे डर लग गया था कहीं पार्टी वाले दुश्मनी ना निकाल लें, इसलिए मुझे डर लगा था करके मैंने सिक्योरिटी मांगी थी.
हाउ डिड यू फील व्हेन यू वन?
मैं जीती उस दिन मुझे कुछ नहीं लगा, मेरे को आम जनता भी आके मेरे साथ ऐसे बैठ के बातचीत चाय पानी पी के चाहते हैं. नेता के आवाज़ से नहीं बोल रही, मैं अपने मन से बोल रही हूँ, मेरा मन ऐसा है.
Have you been able to make the change you wanted since you became a mayor?
लेकिन यहाँ बैठ गई, लेकिन बैठने के बाद साल भर तक, डेढ़ साल तक कोई विकास कार्य नहीं हुआ, क्योंकि भेदभाव चालू कर दिए कर्मचारी अधिकारी जो भी थे, सब भेदभाव करना चालू कर दिए. तो निगम में कोई सपोर्ट नहीं मिला मेरे को, सारे वार्डों में कार्य जो भी कार्य होता था सब रुक गया, कोई कार्य नहीं हो पाया, बहुत दिक्कत गया डेढ़ साल तक. अब मुझे लगता है कि मुझे कोई दिक्कत नहीं, अब मैं बहुत अच्छे से चला रही हूँ.
What changed in a year and a half?
फाइल मेरे तक नहीं आते थे, सबकी जानकारी लेना चालू किए हम लोग, फिर जाके पता चला कितना घोटाला कौन किया क्या उन्होंने किया, और जब को अपनी लाइन पिलाने चालू किए तब से सब सपोर्टिंग करने चालू कर दे कि मेरा पोलो ना खोल दें, उनका पोलो ना खोल दें करके, तब से आप ठीक चल रहा है निगम अपना.
How has the Supreme Court ruling changed your life personally?
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने हम लोग को आज इज्जत सम्मान के लिए जो ये किया है, लाभ हुआ है, यही तो है. मेयर बनी हूँ, आज समाज में इज्जत है और नाम है, और कहीं भी जाने सम्मान मिलता है.
I find you inspiring. You face double discrimination, poverty and transgender. And you came victorious at the end.
किस्मत है सब.
It's quite amazing to move from a beggar in the street to a mayor. It speaks a lot about Indian society, Indian democracy. There are about 2 million people who identify themselves as third gender in India. The biggest impact of the Supreme Court on their lives is that it gave them dignity. And with dignity, they are trying to change the story. From an ostracized community that only shows up in entertainments or in begging in the streets, to now taking a formal role in the society, such as being a mayor. That Supreme Court ruling changed a major narrative, not only in India, but I think and I hope for the whole world. And the story continues.